The point B of a line capital AB is on horizontal plane. The top view of the line makes an angle of 30 degree with XY line being 80 mm. The point A is on the vertical plane and 50 mm above horizontal plane. Draw the top and front views of the line and obtain the true length of the line. Also find the inclination of the line with the two planes. So this is the problem. The point A is on the vertical plane, so obviously that point will going to lie on the horizontal plane. And 50 mm above HP, when you look from the front view, you can see the distance above HP, which is going to be A dash, and then mark this point as A dash. The point B of a line is on the horizontal plane, so obviously that point will going to be seen in the vertical plane. So that means this will going to be the locus of B in the front view. And the top view of the line makes an angle of 30 degree with XY line being 80 mm. With A as center, take the radius, measure the angle of 30 degree and draw an inclined line. And then with A as center, take the compass, cut an arc on this 30 degree line for a radius of 80 mm because the top view line distance is given. So you're going to get this point as B, which is the top view. Then join A and B with a dark line, which is going to be the top view line. So you're going to get the locus of B in the top view. Once you get the locus of B in the top view and you also have the locus of B in the front view, so you'll be able to find the true length and its inclination. So since we have the top view point of B, so you draw a vertical projector from B to the vertical plane so that the locus of B and B is on the horizontal plane. So that image will going to be here. So that point will be on the XY line. So you join A dash B dash with the dark line. So which will going to be the front view and this will going to be the top view. So we need to find out the true length in the vertical plane. So since we need to find out the true length in the vertical plane, you make the line which is inclined to vertical inclined to VP. You make that line parallel to VP. With A is already in VP, so you rotate with A as center, take the radius of AB, then draw an arc such that B will going to touches VP. So AB1 is parallel to VP. Since AB1 is parallel to VP, so you are getting the true length in BP, that is A dash B1 dash is the line which is going to be in true length in VP. But B1 dash is already on HP, so B1, it is a case of B1 which is both on horizontal plane and also on the vertical plane. So A dash B1 dash is the line which is going to be the true length in the vertical plane. The inclination made by this with respect to HP will be theta. That is the one which we are going to be able to find out. So NA is on VP and NB is on the horizontal plane. So this is the line which is in space. So actually what we are doing is with A as center, take the radius of AB, draw an arc. We are rotating this point B such that both A and B will be on the vertical plane. Once you both A and B are on the vertical plane, then naturally that will going to be the true length which is going to be done. Now similarly, we will going to find out the true length in HP. So how to find out the true length in HP is with A as center, take the radius of AB, rotate the point B such that B2 is also above HP by 50 mm. So naturally this line will going to be the line which is in space, which is parallel to HP. Once you get it is parallel to HP, so you're going to get the true length in HP. So when you look from the top view only, you're going to find the true length in HP. Draw a vertical projector from here, A will be on VP, and when you draw this line, this will going to be projected. So with that you're going to get it on the locus of B, such that you're going to get this point small B2 because you are looking from the top view. So since this line which is parallel to HP, so you're going to get this point as capital A and capital B2. Then join A and B2 with a little bit thicker line than the projector line. So the inclination made by this true length with respect to VP is fine. But actually how it will going to be done in the 3D space is with A as center, you take the radius of VB. So once you are rotating like this, what happens? The path traced by this will going to be, since we are taking this in space, when you are looking from the front view, it will going to be, the image will going to be on B dash. So with A dash, B dash as center, with A dash as center, by retaking the radius of A dash, B dash, we are drawing an arc such that B2 dash is also above HP by 50 mm. So that A dash, B2 dash is the line which is parallel to HP. So that is what we have done here when you are rotating in space. So this is the line which is going to be parallel. So it is going to be rotated in the vertical plane such that both B2 and B2 dash both will be above HP by 50 mm. So now the line is parallel to HP. So you are getting the true length in HP. So you are projecting from B2 dash to the XY line, and from there you are drawing the vertical projector such that it is going to cut the locus of B in the top view. So you are going to get this point small B2. Then join AB2 with little bit darker than the projector line. So since this is true length in HP, so since this line is parallel to HP, so you are getting the true length here. So mark that as capital A and capital B2. So this is how we will be able to analyze this three dimension. Now we will going to solve this problem in sketchbook. First we will going to draw the XY line and mark VP and HP as shown. The end A is on the vertical plane, so it will be on the XY line in the top view, because since it is on the vertical plane, the image will going to perform on the horizontal plane. And 50 mm above HP, so from XY line you measure 50 mm and draw a horizontal line which is parallel to VP. HP. So you're going to get, consider any point and draw a vertical line so that A will going to cuts on the locus line, I mean XY line, and A dash will be on above HP. So it will be A dash. Then NB on the horizontal plane. Since NB is on the horizontal plane, the image will going to be seen on the vertical plane. So this will going to be the locus of B in the front view. But this locus of B has to return above the XY line, like here, like here. And the top view of the line makes an angle of 30 degree with XY line being 80 mm. So he has given the top view line, which is by using the protractor, you measure an angle of 30 mm with respect to the XY line and draw an inclined line, measure that and mark a point and draw an inclined line at an angle of 30 degrees with respect to VP, which is seen in HP. Then you take the, by using the compass, you measure the distance of 80 mm with A as center, cut an arc on that inclined line. So you're going to get this point B. So once you get this point B, then you are going to get the locus of B in the top view. So you are going to join A and B with a dark line. Then he says the point B of a line is on the horizontal plane. So since it is on the horizontal plane, it will going to be on the vertical plane here. So the locus of B will be above XY line. So since we have the locus of B in the front view and also in the top view, so you know the AB distance, which is the top view. So always the distance between the end projector will cut the locus. So with B as center, with B draw a vertical projector so that it is brought to XY line, so that B dash will be on the XY line. So then join A dash B dash with the dark line. So this will going to be the front view and this will going to be the top view. So now we will going to find out the true length in the vertical plane so that we can measure the true inclination with respect to HP. So since we need to find out the true length in VP, make the line, take the inclined line in the inclined to VP. So which is the line which is inclined to VP, that is the top view. So with A as center, take the radius of AB and draw an arc such that A is in VP. So B1 dash will also, B1 will also become VP. So now the line AB1 is now the parallel to VP. Once you have the line parallel to VP, therefore we can find the true length in the vertical plane. A is already in VP, but A is above HP and B1 is already on VP. B1 is on VP. So since B1 is on VP and B1 dash is already on HP, so this is the case wherein both on HP and VP. So this will going to be the locus of B in the front view. So here, from mark this point as B1 dash, because this is B1, then join A dash B1 dash with little bit thicker than the projector line. So since A B1 is parallel to VP, so you are getting this line true length. So measure the angle with respect to HP is theta. Similarly, now we need to find out the true length in HP. So to find the true length in HP, so make the line make the line parallel to HP, which is the line which has to be made parallel to HP, the line which is inclined to HP. So the line which is inclined to HP is A dash B dash. With A dash as center, take the radius of A dash B dash and rotate it, make it parallel to HP. Since A dash B2 dash is parallel to HP, that means both A dash and B2 dash is above HP by 50 mm. So once you get this 15 mm above HP, so A dash B2 dash is the line which is parallel to HP, then you are projecting into the top view so that it will going to cut the in the top view and the locus of B at this point. So you are going to get this point B2. Since the line is parallel to HP, so you are getting the true length in HP. So capital A, mark this as capital A and capital B, so which will be the true join A and B2 with little bit thicker than the projector line. So you mark this point AB2. So this will going to be the true inclination with respect to VP, which is phi. Then by using the protractor, you measure the true inclination with respect to HP, which is theta, which is 32.01. When you are doing it in computer, when you are doing it in manual, it will be 32 degrees. Similarly, the true inclination with respect to VP, which is phi, which is going to be At the 25.09 when it is doing it on computer, but when you are doing it in manual, it will be 25 degrees. By using the scale, you measure the length of the true length in the front view and as well as in the top view. Both will going to have equal length, which is going to be 94.34 when you are doing it in CAD. When you are doing it in manual, it will be 94 mm. So this is how we will be able to solve this problem in the sketchbook. So now we are going to analyze it in step by step. So first, what we have done is, here we have considered XY line and marked VP and HP. NDA is in VP and above HP by 50 mm, you mark that. So NB is in horizontal plane, so image will going to be on the vertical plane, and the distance in front of, then the top view of the line makes an angle of 30 degree with respect to XY line and being 80 mm, so you are going to get the top view. Once you get the top view, so we know that top view line is known, so we have the locus of B in the top view and also the locus of B in the front view. So since B is here, so the distance between the end projectors in the both front view and top view will going to be the same. So when you are projecting this, so this will going to be the distance between the end projectors. So it will always cut the locuses. So B is here, it is already cut on the locus of B in the top view. So you are projecting this such that B dash will going to get on the XY line, because B is on HP, so image will be on VP. So you got this B dash, join A dash B dash with a dark line. So now we need to find out true length in vertical plane. So true length in vertical plane may be find out by considering the line which is inclined to VP. So with A as center, take the radius of AB and draw an arc such that AB1 will going to be parallel to VP, because A is in VP, B1 is also in VP. So the line AB1 is line parallel to VP. But B1 dash is already an HP, because that is already given in the problem, which is locus of B. So join A dash B1 dash with a little bit thicker line than the true length projector line. So then by using the protractor, you measure an angle with respect to HP, which will be theta. So this is how we have done with the as center. We take the radius and you rotate it so that it is made parallel to VP. So we are getting the true length here. So measure true length and also the true inclination with respect to HP in the first. Then in the second step, we can see. Now once you do that, now we have the front view. So you make a line which is parallel to HP with A dash as center. Take the radius of A dash B dash. Draw an arc such that A dash B2 dash which is parallel to HP. So that is what we have done with A as center. Take the radius of AB. When you rotate it, make AB2 parallel to HP. That is A is above HP by 50 mm. Capital B2 is also above HP by 50 mm in the space. So when it is projected onto the front view, that A dash B2 dash which is parallel to HP. So when you are rotating like this, what happens? Here in the vertical plane also, with A dash as center, A dash B dash as the radius, you draw an arc such that A dash B2 dash is parallel to HP. So once you get this, so you are going to get the true length in HP. So from B2 dash, you draw a vertical projector to the locus, to the XY line, and from this point, you draw a vertical projector again, tilt to the locus of B in the top view, so that you are going to get small AB2. So this is the line which is going to be the true length, because that line is parallel to HP. So we are finding the true length in HP. So join AB2 with little bit thicker than the projector line. So since this line is parallel to HP, so you are getting B2 here and also capital A here. So this is the line. So when you are projecting, so when you are projecting like this, you are going to get this, and that is, so you are projecting from here to here, so you are projecting from here to here. And you are projecting from here to here, so you are projecting from here to here, so this will go to be the line. So this is how we will be able to solve this problem here. So that's what we have done with A as center, A dash as center, take the radius of A dash B dash and rotate it, make it parallel to HP. So you are getting parallel to HP here. Then you are projecting this B2 dash onto the locus of B in the front view, I mean top view, so that you are going to get this point B2. Since this line is parallel to HP, so you are getting the true length here. So you mark this as capital A and capital B. Then join AB2 with little bit darker than the projector line. So the inclination made by this with respect to VP is the one which can be found out here. Thereby, we are finding out the true length, the inclination with true inclination with respect to VP, and also the true inclination with respect to HP. So this is how we will be able to solve the problem.